Thanks, Laura. The Franklin Institute. It stands on the corner of 20th and the Ben Franklin Parkway in the heart of Philadelphia. Founded in 1824, the Franklin Institute has always served as one of the nation's great centers for science and education. As a native son of Philadelphia, I couldn't wait to relive my youth roaming through its grand halls and exhibits. Benjamin Franklin, scientist, inventor, statesman, writer, craftsman, and educator, became an institution in his own time and the namesake for an institute dedicated to his lifelong passion for learning, knowledge, and science.
One of our missions here at the Franklin Institute is to really expose the science that is in the everyday life around you.
Or even inside you, like, say, behind that breastbone of yours. You know, that tick-tick-ticking muscle, the heart. It's really one of the most popular organs in the body and at the Institute.
Of course, we still have the giant heart. It's been here at the Franklin Institute for over a century. It is a must-see for anyone coming into Philadelphia. And it really represents the heart of what would be a 220-foot tall person.
The full exhibit walks you through the whole human cardio system and even gives you a chance to simulate pumping blood like the heart does. It makes you appreciate how much work the old ticker does 24/7.
I like the heart.
My favorite exhibit was the heart. I really liked it. I teach anatomy, so that was really fun to see some of the inner workings of the heart.
Hey, if you like the heart, you're going to love the brain, especially your brain. You'll find it in the new 53,000-square-foot Nicholas and Athenia Karabatz Pavilion.
The crown jewel of the pavilion is Your Brain, which is a brand new neuroscience exhibit, the largest in the country, featuring over 70 interactives.
I checked out Your Brain and really got into the whole neural network thing.
The big children's activity inside Your Brain is what we call the neural climb, and it allows kids and adults of all ages to climb through what it would be like to be inside the neural network.
And it's 12 feet tall, and you can really see how one nerve is connected to another nerve, but more importantly, you see how they aggregate together.
If you're my age, your brain will send signals to your lower back saying, hey, let the kids climb the neural network. Why don't you just stroll down the exhibit street of illusions? Here you'll learn about perception and how the brain sees things. For example, you'll pass this graphic. Some brains see a young lady. Others see an older woman. Just down the block, there's a room that throws all your normal perceptions out the window. Yikes!
And when our visitors go through your brain, they are really studying their own brain, how it works, how it reacts, and when they come out, their brain is going to be different.
Especially if they stop by the brain bar to hold a real brain on the way out.
It's alive! It's alive! It's alive.
We did the brain, we all climbed through the webbing they had there.
After your brain, I hit the train. Talk about perceptions, wow! You walk into the train factory and there, like some kind of iron mammoth, stands the Baldwin 60,000 steam locomotive, built in 1926.
The locomotive was actually brought into the Franklin Institute in 1933. It was at 24th and Vine, and it literally took 5 days to get it from there to the inside of the Franklin Institute.
It's fun to imagine yourself operating this 318-ton monster, although it never really took off. Turns out it was too complex and heavy, and the model was scrapped. But if you like speed, check out the Franklin Air Show.
And I did the flight simulator with my son today, and we were going upside down and all around. That was fun.
Science and technology, fun? Well, yes, that's how the Franklin Institute draws more than 850,000 children and adults a year. The folks there make it fun, with 12 permanent exhibits and interactive features from weather to astronomy, from medicine to sports, and even history.
We get people excited, we get people engaged, we want them to have fun.
I want an anti Institute.
Somehow, I think Dr. Franklin would give the museum, which bears his name, a hearty thumbs up. For Focus, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.